Title, Hellfire Redemption. Chapter 1, The Fiery Ultimatum. Adam Pearce, the stern-faced general manager of WWE Monday Night Raw, paced back and forth in his office. His fingers drummed on the polished wooden desk as he replayed the footage from last week's Raw. Finn Balor, the enigmatic Irishman and the leader of the stable The Judgment Day, had unleashed a brutal assault on R-Truth, leaving the veteran superstar battered and bruised. Pearce clenched his jaw. He couldn't let such behavior slide. The locker room needed discipline, and Balor was about to learn that actions had consequences. He picked up the phone and dialed Balor's number. Balor, Pierce's voice was icy. Report to my office immediately. Chapter 2, The Devil's Bargain. Finn Balor entered the office, his jet-black leather jacket clinging to his slim and athletic frame. His eyes narrowed as he faced Pearce. What's the problem, Adam? Pearce leaned back in his leather chair, studying Balor. The problem, Finn, is your lack of control. You attacked R-Truth without provocation. That's unacceptable. Balor's lips curled into a half-smile. R-Truth had it coming. He disrespected me in the Judgment Day. Pearce raised an eyebrow. Disrespect or not, you crossed the line. I'm fining you 10 grand. Balor's eyes widened. 10 grand? Are you kidding me? No jokes, Balor, Pearce snapped. But I'll reconsider if you face an opponent of my choosing at Hell in a Cell in a Hell in a Cell match. Balor's curiosity peaked. Who? Pearce leaned forward, his voice dropping to a whisper. The big red machine himself, Kane. Chapter 3, Hellfire Showdown. The Hell in a Cell pay-per-view loomed like a storm on the horizon. Balor stood in the dimly lit backstage area, his heart pounding. The steel structure awaited him, a twisted playground of pain. Across the corridor, Kane's massive silhouette emerged from the shadows. You wanted redemption, Kane's gravelly voice echoed. You'll find it in the flames. See you out there. Good luck. Kane came out with his old entrance music that he used during the Attitude Era. Balor swallowed hard. He'd faced demons, but none like Kane. He came out of it with his demon gear with his demon entrance. Both demon gladiators are in the ring. The crowd roared as the cell lowered, encasing them in darkness. The crowd chanted, "This is awesome." The bell rang, and the match began. Who will win this bout? Watch the video to find out.
this man knows it's one thing to face Finn Balor, but it is a completely different experience when you are staring across the ring at the Demon.
Five-ton structure made of 2,700 feet of chain link does not judge, but it punishes. It rewards evil and shows no mercy. It will not relent.
Only the men and women who have stepped inside this demonic structure know just how unrelenting it is. And there isn't a soul alive who doesn't have trepidation when they step inside this cell.
I'm just near the cell and I'm feeling uneasy.
Perhaps looking for some kind of equalizer here. He returns to the ring. Now on the outside, right by those cell walls. Outside of the ring now.
What's the plan here? Oh.
Into the ring now.
Doctor.
Man, what an uppercut.
Squaring off right by our announce table.
Solid punch.
This match may be nearing its limit.
Yeah, this is not good.
You don't say, Saxton.
Oh!
And here we go. Business picking up as he starts to climb the cell.
This is where superstars become legends, Cole.
Guys, he clearly has no regard for his own well-being.
He gave you the first hit, Byron.
Look at that gash on the face of Kane.
Nothing to catch their fall. It's one of them loses their grip here.
I think that's the evil intent. Looking to pry each other off the cell.
Ooh. They say the only way out of hell is up, but I don't think they're heading towards salvation.
Ooh. Bashing each other on the side of the cell, but to what end?
I don't think there's any end, Saxton. I don't think there's an end until someone gets taken out of here on a stretcher.
Guys, this is really dangerous.
There's no training for fighting on the side of a 25-foot steel structure.
Interrupting their climb on the cell, forced to do battle on the side of this demonic structure.
One mistake could be your undoing here.
Fighting on the side of the cell?
And there's only two directions to go from here.
Here he goes, right on the side of the cell.
Making it look easy.
Oh, if you ask me, this doesn't seem like the brightest of ideas.
And it's great, Corey, you're right. Was ready for that.
Knee right to the gut.
him off at the pass. Oh! Making his way up the cell wall.
Apparently, he loves chaos. I must say, he's got impressive driving skills.
You're the best fighter. I can't tell if this is insanely stupid or smart.
How did it fix a bone?
He's on top of the cell now.
Why is he on top of the cell?
I think we're about to find out.
Yokes up their opponent.
Sidewalk slam delivered.
This is truly awesome. He uses an elbow to disrupt that attack. Down with a sling blade.
And a big drop kick. You could hear the chain link fence buckling.
Stopped him in the tracks with a kick to the guts.
a shred of doubt right now.
Uh-oh, this is just vicious.
Soon.
Oh,
he's had enough, but it doesn't even matter in this scenario. An end to this.
Talk about stubbornness. It certainly paid off here tonight, but who knows if that'll be the case next time around.